Tickets for that. Thanks, Brothers and Fox Raya, on February 2nd. So we're going to give those away just after. vacation. It's in the zone. Hello, it's Maxine. It's been quite a while since I posted, maybe 6-7 months. Well, for any sort of vlog or subject. This is my natural face, like completely no makeup. I have really bad rosacea. It's been like that since I was young, but it got worse with age, and I thought like not wearing makeup would help things out, because like I barely wear makeup as often as I used to, but it doesn't help with the rosacea. Sometimes I wake up and it doesn't look so bad, and then as the day goes on, or if I eat maybe some of my food sensitivities, since I have so many, I think that causes a reaction a bit. But yeah, I wanted to have a get ready with me and do a life update. So I'm gonna do my makeup while I chat with you. And I have my iced coffee. I'm trying to support more local businesses these days, not big, you know, like the usual like places for coffee. So, one thing I'm really adamant on is like buying cruelty-free as often as I can and vegan. So I like Elf stuff because it's really affordable. So yeah, I'm just gonna put it right on. So last time I posted a video, clown. Like, look at such a drastic difference in color. Anyway, oh, great. So anyway, there's people walking around, so I'm feeling self-conscious. Anyway, yeah, last time I posted, I was talking about how I cried at my interview. I was just like really looking forward to this job, and I was like so sure I was gonna get it, and then you know, I just wasn't really prepared at all for the questions that they were gonna ask. And so I learned from that experience, and the next job that I interviewed for, I got it, and I actually worked for them for 3 months, and it's like a big, well-known delivery company. I won't say who, but there are things I really liked about it, like mainly driving, being independent on my own during the day. You know, I didn't really have to interact with like employees or like or coworkers or my employers very often, just like at the beginning of the day, the end of the day, it wasn't very much. It was really hard, like the amount of parcels just like going up and down the stairs, and I was starting to get in like really good shape. Like I'm
I'm pretty sure I lost like 20 pounds of fat, but I gained like 10 pounds of muscle right away because like I was, my stomach was like getting super flat and my legs were just like getting ripped in a really short time frame. And the summer was freaking brutal though. Like when it was like plus 30 degrees, it was like plus 40 degrees in the back of the van. And there was a time where I just like, I got a nosebleed because it was just like, I had to have the AC cranked, and going from the AC to the hot outside to the back of the van, it's like three extreme temperatures. I think like that my tip for anyone deciding to do delivery is to probably not use the AC as often as possible and just have the windows down, because it's like going, changing temperatures is like pretty hard on the body. But the only reason I didn't like just leaving the windows down is because I couldn't just like put the windows up and down between each stop. You're just going so much that it would be like a waste of time, and I would have my belongings in my vehicle and I didn't want to like leave the windows down and have anything stolen. But anyway, so the biggest complaint I had, and I think people should be aware of this, because you know, when you get parcels, you're letting your kids and your animals play in these boxes. Well, you probably don't realize that some of the drivers are smoking and vaping, and all of that smoke is going to the back where all the parcels are. And the thing that sucked most about it is I had my own van 4 days a week. It was 10-hour shifts. And I've been doing this for so long, I'm sure it's good by now. But people were smoking in my van, and like my employers just didn't really seem to like care so much until I voiced my opinion about it like quite a few times. And then eventually I had my own van, but on the days off, on my days off, someone else would be in the van, and they always claimed that they wouldn't let people who smoke in the van on my days off. But there was a time where I came back and there was garbage in it and there was a pack of smoke. So I'm like, oh, thanks for your effort. I mean, obviously they can't control people, and like people are gonna do what they're gonna do, but I just think that they should have taken it more seriously, because like that's a health concern. Like there's just ash everywhere, and I'm like starting my shift cleaning the van every day, and like in the 3 months that I was there, no one else cleaned any of the vans. Just a select few of us would actually clean the vans, so that was another thing that was pretty disgusting. And anyway, so that's what I didn't like about the job. And because the reason I'm so against and have such like a like hatred for cigarette smoke is because my dad was a chain smoker. And so growing up, the walls were like yellow in the house, and he would smoke like whether we were in the room or not. He'd never smoked outside, and he'd smoke in the car with us, and it just really sucked. Like I know for a fact it affected my lungs, because I had like lung issues until I like moved out of the house, and I haven't really had them since. And at times I had asthma, and I whenever I got sick and it was like a lung infection, it would get to the point where it was so bad that I could barely breathe. And it just makes me anxious even thinking about it. But anyway, so it just sucks that, and the other thing I really hated was, so like I said, like my employers were nice for the most part. Like it was just brief, short interactions. Actually, there were some things that like really bothered me about them right off the bat. I'm not going to say specifics because I don't want to like get myself in trouble or whatever, but the thing that I hated was like the way that they treated other employees, like, or their employees. I noticed that there was kind of like favoritism towards some of the so the company that I worked for is like a third party company for the big well-known company. So there's three third party companies, and I saw the way the other two third party companies interacted with their employees, and it seemed like mutual respect, and they wanted to like get to like find out how their day was or say thank you, and you know, like actual communication. And then with my company, they just so happened to like, it was just really odd, like really negative and like not very personable, and then only showing favoritism and joking around with certain people. And you know, it almost just made me cry once, like not for the way they're treating me. I didn't really care, because like I said, it was like 10 minutes in the morning, 10 minutes at the end of the day. Like, so what if they want it? That's their problem, not mine. But you know, we're working our butts off. Just imagine you're working out in the extreme heat, 10-hour day. You just accomplished your goals. Like you dropped off all your parcels. You came back and you say, okay, have a good night to, your boss, and they just completely ignore you. Like, it's not like a one-time thing. I saw this all the time, and it just made me feel so bad. Like, this guy's just smiling, and he's like just completely ignored. And this happened more than once, like I said, and it just, things like that were starting to really get to me. So like between the smoke and the job itself, I mean, I kind of have like gotten past that point where I don't even think about the negative aspects of the job, like, you know, like nuisances, like having to buzz people in apartments and they're not home or wherever the case may be, like things like just, or, you know, someone honking at me because I'm taking up too much room on the road. Well, some of the streets in Victoria and the surrounding areas are pretty narrow, so, and there's only so, like, this person could have got around, or they could have waited literally 30 seconds, like, just things like that, things that, like, don't really matter. But, anyway, oh, so, eventually, though, I think I was just, like, expressing that I was like dissatisfied with how, you know, they told me that the vans were going to get cleaned when they went in for oil change, and that didn't happen. And so as far as I'm concerned, these vans don't get cleaned all year round, and we're talking like spit when you're talking, and food and crumbs and dust and skin cells and like cigarettes for the people smoking, like ash and just everything, like filthy conditions. And then, so for them to just, I can't do this. I can't tell a story and do my makeup at the same time. But, anyway, and you know, like for some reason, this person, I don't even know the name of this person, like answered the phone, and they were really rude to me. So I just lost it, and I just quit right on the spot. I'm like, I'm not doing this. I don't like the way they treat people. I don't like the filthy conditions. There's like a number of things where I'm just like, I can take my experience and find better. No one deserves this. So I quit, and I put in a complaint with HR, and meanwhile, they're asking me questions and talking to me for a full hour, and then, like, maybe 2 months later, they're like, we did our investigation, and there was nothing was wrong. It's like, okay, well, clearly you didn't do your job, because I told you, like, several violations and, like, anyway. No one cares anymore. Like, when you go to Walmart or you go to certain stores, like, they're just filthy nowadays, and I'm just one of those people, like, where I want to try to make a difference and, like, help people. Like, I called because this big, well-known store, their, like, where their drinks was, like, disgustingly filthy and, like, full of mold and I don't even know what. And finally, after I, like, told the people who worked there a few times, they didn't get anything done. And this is over the span of, like, several weeks, if not months. So then I finally called their head office or whatever, and then finally it was done. And I was just thinking, like, this is like post pandemic, like, where, you know, like, so cleanliness is just out the window now. Like, when you go to those self checkouts and they're just filthy, but, you know, someone's going to grab a drink from there, drink it, their hands touching that bottle where it's, like, disgusting in the fridge. Like, that can make people sick. Anyway, so from there, like, one positive is I actually, like, have found a job since then. It's, like, I'm really proud of myself for getting in here because, you know, they do a pretty thorough, background check and, you know, like, a whole bunch of things. And I don't want to say what it is, and I'm not going to say, like, anything to give it away, but, yeah, it's where I hope to see myself long term. Hopefully, like, my videos don't affect anything with them. Like, I'm talking about basic human subjects, from employment to autism to my past trauma and a whole bunch of array of subjects. And I mean, I don't party anymore. I've never really experimented with drugs, and I don't drink, and I, like, there should be no reason that anything in my videos will affect this job. Like, so it is in the back of my head, but I'm like, I still want to do these because I'm hoping to reach out to, or, you know, to help others, like, in similar situations, or just to vent, and, yeah, I should have just done a video and not done this at the same time, because it's, like, I'm having a hard time, but, yeah, there's my eyebrows so far. Like, I have, like, five hairs per brow. So, it's hard to do. Like, from not doing my makeup all the time and not, doing my eyebrows all the time, they're actually growing back. So, I'm trying to do them as seldom as I can these days. Okay, so I have this brow mascara that kind of helps thicken them up a bit. Like, my eyelashes are long, but they're so thin and light that, like, they look barely there, but when you see after mascara how long and thick they get. Raining out. anyway, I loved working for the past place I was talking about in some regards, because I was like, I can't have a job where I'm just sitting all day. I have to be active, otherwise I'm just gonna stay lazy. It's like very hard to, outside of work, like find the motivation to get active when you're sitting all day, and it makes me feel sick and it makes me feel sore. So yeah, I was like getting in good shape. I wasn't like out of breath while I was talking. My double chin was going away, but now it's like she's back for revenge, because my new job is physically demanding a bit as well, but the hours aren't as much. It's like, hopefully I'm going to work my way up eventually. Some weeks have been great, others not so much. After Christmas time especially, but anyway, here's, yeah, cruelty free, just like a lip balm, avocado lip balm. I'm feeling self-conscious because there's people walking. They're gonna say, oh my god, is she does she think she's YouTube famous? Yep, I'm on my way, guys. Just kidding. I don't ever intend to like be full-time YouTuber. I just it's something I do for fun. Like, I like doing the shorts. I want to make more videos on different topics, so I have a lot more to talk about, and hopefully you can reach out and help others. Oh, my lips are super dry. The way I did my lips right now is like early 2000s or mid to late 2000s with concealer over it. I'll fix it in a little bit. Let's see what's next. It's been so long. Before I do my eyes, I think I'm gonna do bronzer. Delete the chin. This is really not what I usually do. I usually have a better brush for this, but not today. So I'll just make do. A bit too dark for winter. But it's all I have right now. So, I think I'll just do like a, all I really have is like nothing ever goes to plan. I haven't done my makeup in a while, so I'm like, oh yeah, I'm just gonna do a light, like nice light nude, a little liner, and then when all's said and done, I end up looking like a raccoon. Oh well, go big or go home. Oh, it's a mess. Oh my God, it's really bad. Really, really. This will still make it to video. Yuck. Anyway. Oh well, today I'm just going to pick up cat litter and then I'm going home. She was this. I ran out of room. Anyways, I will do this 1,000% better next time. Everything's bad, from the eyebrows to the eyes to the lips to the skin. Doesn't even look good from afar either. Usually when I do my eyes this dark, at least my eyes pop, the color looks nice, but no, not even that looks good. Okay, well, see you later.